In this lesson, you will learn how to generate macros automatically using Excel. If you have a series of tasks that need to be completed many times in the workbook environment, you may find it convenient to record your actions and then assign them to a shortcut key. We can accomplish this task by going to Developer and selecting Record Macro. A pop-up window appears where you can write your macro name, the shortcut key, and determine where you want to store your macro. You can store your macro in either your personal macro workbook, the current workbook, or a brand new workbook. Choosing personal macro workbook will allow you to use the macro in other workbooks as well. For this example, I will store the macro in this workbook. The macro name will be macro 88, and the shortcut key will be Control plus Shift plus P. After I click on the OK button, all my actions will be recorded and converted into VBA code automatically for me. Notice at the top of the screen, it now reads Stop Recording. All my actions on the workbook will be recorded until I click the Stop Recording button. For this simple example, I will create a column of X values and the corresponding sine of X values. Now that I'm done, I will click on the Stop Recording button. Now I have a macro that can be run on any worksheet by typing Control plus Shift plus P. The macro will then create two columns of data containing the values of X and sine of X, starting at A1 and going all the way to B6. Let's delete this data and type Control Shift P, and we can see the data has been regenerated. I am currently on sheet 2. If I click on sheet 1 and type Control Shift P, again, I regenerate the data. If you'd like to look at the VBA code generated for this macro, click on Macros, Macro 88, and edit. Sometimes the VBA code that is automatically generated is more complicated than necessary, but it can be a valuable learning tool to help you learn how commands in VBA will be translated to the workbook environment. By default, the recorded macros use absolute references. Every time you execute your macro, the same actions will be performed on the exact same cells. If you want the commands to be performed on cells relative to the current active cell that you select, you can click the Use Relative References button before recording your macro. Let's record another macro using relative references. Before recording our macro, we select Use Relative References, and let's delete the data on our workbook before recording our new macro. So we go back up to Record Macro, and let's call this macro Macro 99. And we will run the macro by typing Control, Shift, and Q. I'll click OK and then repeat the same actions as before. I go to the top and click Stop Recording. I can now go to any cell in my workbook and type Control Shift Q, and the two columns of data will be created starting from the cell that I select.